Alright, hello everyone and welcome back. This is part 11 of my Witcher 3 Blood and Wine Let's Play series. As a recap for part 10, we competed in the Knights Tourney, did the archery section after playing some Gwent with our buddy Palmerin, did some horseback riding and sort of sucked on that but made out okay, then competed in the sort of swordsmanship battle at the end. And afterwards fought Sir Gregoire. I call him the Mountain because he's similar to the Mountain from Game of Thrones. But we defeated him. We're the tourney champion. Along the way, we learned that Vivienne has been cursed and is sort of stuck as a half-bird creature. So what we're about to go do now is go with her to find an oriole egg and transfer her curse onto that oriole. Break the egg and kill the oriole and give her at least 7 years of life back. So let's get started into that.
Oh no! A panther's gotten at the nest!
Stand back. I'll take care of this.
Easy enough.
Eggs fell in a moss patch. They're fine except for one. It's cracked.
Will it do?
Think so.
That bird again. I think there's something with that bird. Maybe that's the creature that
now
cursed
what
her?
What must I do?
Yeah, let's sort of make sure that she's fine with this and wants to only have 7 years of life left.
Just to be sure, gonna ask one last time. Positive you want to do this? If we succeed, the changes will be irreversible. You'll probably also only have 7 years left to live, at the most.
7 years free of the fear that someone might spy me at the wrong moment? Of the stigma of being a freak, a monster? 7 years of a life both true and unfettered? Yes, Geralt. I'm certain I wish to do it.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, nothing that we're going to be able to say to dissuade her from her choice. I guess we'll continue with trying to transfer the curse over then.
You need to concentrate now. Repeat after me. Muna Gandrau. Muna Finerat.
Muna Gandrau. Muna Finerat. Muna Gandrau. Muna Finerat. Muna Gandrau. Muna Finerat.
Whoa. I think it worked. But knocked us out. Holy crap. Oh, the medallion.
Geralt, look. Look. Oh, gods. I shall be able to attend balls. I shall travel to Oxenford, to Novigrad even. Thank you, Witcher.
Not to thank Guillaume. He's the one hired me to help you.
Yes, I'm grateful to him as well, immensely.
No.
Will you tell him so for me?
No. Yeah, why don't you just go tell him yourself?
Should tell him yourself, don't you think?
Perhaps I should, but I would prefer not to. Convey my gratitude to him in my stead. Please, be so kind.
All right, we'll be a nice guy. We'll help you out, even though Guillaume's not going to be happy. Nothing much I guess we can really do.
Sure, I'll tell him. Farewell, Vivienne.
Is that other bird going to come along? That's really what I want to know, is what happened to that yellow bird that we kept seeing in the cutscenes. Is that going to come back to us? Is that nothing, something? Why is the frame rate so bad? Alright, let's head back over to our buddy Guillaume and go talk to him. We'll follow the path that it's sort of laying out for us, that way we're not... Alright, yeah, that's... Oh, okay, this was the sort of the path that we went before. Where we had the panthers sort of fighting us, is where we were following that bird the last time. Okay, Roach, come on, turn around, there you go.
Okay.
Alright, we'll sort of take this a little bit slow, that way we're not doing anything bad. Ah, Geralt, you suck. Put that sword away. Where's my other sword? Oh, you can only have the... Wait, do I not have a silver sword anymore? Oh, okay, I was gonna say, like, what the heck happened? Whoa, look at that. Geralt of Rivia's sword. Sure. Even though it's not the Witcher's sword. That's still pretty good, though. One of the things, I don't really like Geralt's armor. I prefer to use the woven armor. Woven trousers back on. Okay, there we go.
Come on.
Oh, look at how gaudy that sort of like hand protection area. I'm not a sword guy. I don't really know the terms. We're not fighting panthers or whatever that was. Let's go talk to our buddy Guillaume. Probably sulking over here.
To win the tourney with your name.
Yeah, I already won the tourney.
Geralt, what of Vivienne?
She dead.
Managed
no,
to
just kidding.
Curse.
Truly? So all will be well. Her troubles are done?
Oh yeah, let me pass on the message first.
Asked me to give you a message. Said she's grateful. Thanks to you, she can live a normal life.
Good, good. But how does she fare?
She seems good. Yeah. I mean, we don't need to, I guess, inform him about the short lifespan she has. Just sort of be like, hey, you know, she's all right. Don't worry. But she doesn't want to see you again. Sorry, Guillaume. Oh, wrong button.
Vivienne chose what suited her best. She's completely free now. And happy, I think.
Without me.
You helped her. But that doesn't mean she owes you her love. Got this bard friend, philosopher too, I guess, amateur. He'd say, if you love somebody, set them free.
Do you know what, Geralt? You earned your reward, so take it. But keep your advice to yourself. Adieu.
Jeez, nobody can get so angry at me.
A fruitful hunt to the Witcher.
It is right and fitting, Witcher. That the Duchess are summoned,
okay. Well, I think our time talking with Guillaume is gone. So yeah, she's free. And now we are going to do another side mission, because why not? Not gonna do that yet. We could do the two foam monster, but I don't feel like we're ready yet. A Knight's Tales. Yeah, I think that this would be better. Doing the Witcher sort of mutations. This guy. The only thing is that we might run into Regis over at the different cemetery. Okay. Regis was like over here. Somewhere, so luckily we're not gonna face him. So what we'll do is we'll fast travel to the Nilfgaarden Embassy, since we're right here, of course, and then maybe go do this available quest or get that available quest and then head over to the graveyard, where we're going to search and hopefully find the information on the Witcher mutations and get that going for us. All right, what do you want?
My eyes were not deceived, yet so far south. You, sir, of all folk in all your fame.
Mm-hmm. Me, south in all my fame.
I've heard so much. Why, when Master Dandelion tarried in Beauclair, not a day passed without him baying out a ballad in admiration of your deeds.
Yeah, unwelcome little habit of his. But what can I do for you?
Ah, you see, my betrothed, Francois Le Goff, vowed in my honor to bring me the head of the horrid beast they call Gratore.
Okay.
Couldn't have gotten you a bouquet, some sweets and a bag.
Witcher, sir, you jest. A love most true demands proof through heroic deeds dedicated to the heart's captor. But alas, Francois has been gone a fortnight. Thus, I must plead with you to see what's become of him. Could you? Would you?
Are you gonna pay me?
Rarely my wont to turn down a damsel in distress, even less so when there's a prize involved.
Ah, naturally. Why, you, sir, are no knight-errant, but a guildsman, an expert. How much would you need?
All of your money. Give me everything. We'll go 360.
Yes. That amount I am prepared to pay.
Okay. Yeah, I'll take a look.
Do my damnedest to get your fiancé back safe and sound. Just, mind telling me where to look for him?
I forget you come from afar and do not know our land. They say Gratore has its lair in the caves at the foot of the Gorgon Hills.
That close to the city? Telling me no bold souls have ventured out to defeat the beast?
Quite the contrary. Plenty have, but none's returned. My concern is well-founded.
I see. All right. High time I set off.
Okay. All right, so let's take a look at that quest, which is a Witcher contract. Level 45, so while we're close enough, I don't... I didn't want to actually do it. Yeah, we're doing that one. Because we're so close, why would I go... Alright, so yeah, we'll go to that other available quest, which seems to be around the corner for us. Woo! Jumping! I don't know if it's inside, up top, yeah. Locked. Okay, how do I get up there then? Oh, I gotta go inside. Okay, yep, upstairs. Okay.
What's this about?
Yeah, what do you want?
Ah, the notice. Is that it? Are you a witcher, master?
Noises at the cemetery. You the one they bother?
Yes, yes. And I'm alone in that, it seems. That is, no one else has bothered to take any steps, though all must hear the racket.
So the cemetery's loud and you want me to check it out?
I took the matter up with the ducal guard. They claim they found nothing, but I'm not sure they even bothered to look. What's left for me to do? Should I sniff about the cemetery myself?
Maybe. Yeah, how much money am I gonna get?
How much will I get for this?
How much would you like?
What the fuck is this? What kind of cheap ass? Alright, we're going 60. What?
I don't believe I have that amount. What would you say to a festival discount? On account of the, tourney.
I won the tourney. You give me money. Oh my, dude, that is...
Fine, I'll tend to it. Any victims? Someone go missing recently? Or are we just talking noises?
No one's come to harm, thank the gods. Why? Do you think it might be a monster?
Dude, I have no
Could
idea.
Be, but doesn't need to, though. Might also be grave robbers, tramps. Remains to be seen.
I can't rightly say what would be worse. Whatever the case, Godspeed, Master.
All right, I guess we've... Let's wait a little bit. I don't want to pick up. I mean, it might even be in the same graveyard. Is it a Witcher contract? No. Okay. So it's till death do you part. Is that the same cemetery? Yeah. Okay. Question is, how do I get into the cemetery? Oh, up these gates. Right.
Can't hear anything, but might want to look around anyway.
I mean, I hear people crying, but then again, it's a cemetery. Okay.
Sure, go on. Drink up.
Empty wine bottles. Leftovers. Big to do? Not likely.
No, it's okay, so that's nothing big. I see something over here.
Graves dug up. Thing is, grave robbers don't usually wail and moan that much.
I'm not gonna take some guy's skull. That's a little bit even beyond Sir Geralt of Rivia.
Tracks?
Ooh, okay. Alright, follow these. Or not. Alright, let's go back a little bit. Okay. Alright, am I being dumb or. Okay, yeah, they go to like right here. Get locked. Alright, that's not helping us. Yeah, seriously, it looks like it goes. Oh, I've got an exam in.
There we go. Grass and bloomers. Not the kind of moaning he meant, though.
Okay.
Lots of tracks. Not much I can glean from them, though.
Alright, so maybe not tracks.
Gotta
then.
Come back after dark.
Okay. Alright, so that seems fine. Well, so we already did most of that then. Let's do Turn and Face the Strange. Since we're already over here. I'm hungry. Got some juicy steak for dinner later today. That's gonna be good. Funny. Alright. Ah, here we go.
Inscriptions in Elder Speech. Salvation lies not in Dolnevde, but in our hearts. Glory be to Eldarin. Damn. Professor's journal's long gone. Guess somebody else found out about it too. Should look around, see if I can find something else.
Okay. So yeah, tracks, of course.
Narrow and shallow. Somebody small, light. Woman, maybe? Wonder where they lead. Damn it, trail breaks off. Wonder if the grave robber learned more than I did.
Okay.
Professor certainly can't do much to help me with my search. Won't learn anything else here. Map Yensemi will have to do.
Okay.
So, epitaph mentioned both Eldarin and Dolnevde, Eldarin 9.
Alright, so let's take a look at our inventory, at our quest items, and look for the map. I don't know if that's the one that Yen sent.
map's all wet now. Saw a tour flows through there. Must be where the Valley of Iron once lay. Need to explore the location.
Okay. So I think that the old map is the one that we needed. Let's sort of take a look if we can fast travel, and we can't. I guess we could. Let's go to the Tassant prison, hop on that boat, and head over that way. We'll come back to the graveyard later in order to do the search for that one mini quest, but we're getting, what, like 56 gold from that guy? Big cheap ass that guy was. Like, hey, help me out with finding out these strange noises, but I don't want to pay you any money. Okay, well, then deuces. Okay, shove off. Let's head over this way. Did a good job with some of the water and the animation that you do when you're on a boat. I like it. Okay, so it seems like we are... Seems like we have found something. Let me go back up. Yeah, okay. So there's something going on. Whoa, a portal. Who's ready to go on a journey?
Must have found something in Moreau's tomb to activate the entry portal. Wonder what surprises this place has in store.
Very cool. Alright, we're searching some old elven ruins. Of course, we are loot masters. So we pick up everything and everything. Because you never know what you can sell.
Spikes. Sick sense of humor someone's got.
Okay. Oh, don't step on those. Oh, yeah, there we go. Okay, let me do some swallow. Eat some more raw meat. Good. Cool. That's a lot easier than sort of running like that. Okay, so we've got spikes all over the place. There we go. Woo! Wow, dude, that sword had a sweet name. Ooh, so good. Oh, damn it, Geralt. You're killing me, dude. Alright, let's head down this way. Ooh, some est-ests. Why are you walking? I was like, I didn't think I pressed control to tell him to walk. I think we're about to have a fight here. Yep, that's what I figured. Alright, hold on. Hold on. Alright, let me throw up a Quinn, a shield. got you. Let me loot that. Okay, let me heal up a little bit. Took a few too many hits. A few more than I would have liked to. Okay, just making sure we're not missing anything. Still got that Quen on us, but it's about to expire. It's probably better that Quen doesn't last forever. Okay. So it seems like going that way is the way to go. However, there's... Is this another entrance or something?
Blood-soaked. Grave Robber was wounded while attempting the climb. Needed to bandage up. Managed to avoid the panthers, at least.
Okay, don't go that way. You will die. So yeah, this seems to be the alternate way to go. Yeah, because we came from over there. Stuck in a loop. Okay, good. Ooh. Alright, we got stuck in a weird loop being on the... What, stalactites? Dude, I wanted to jump and see... Alright, this is not worth it. Okay, come on. Okay, we are stuck. Rats. Ah. What the hell? Did I just get an achievement for a glitch, I guess? Dude, I don't even know. Refined copper ore, some Nostrix. Got a chest with quite a bit of stuff in it, so... Alright, no more jumping over there. That's leading us nowhere, and it's pissing me off and making me sweat a little bit. Got some blood moss. Did we find the grave robber, or... No, not yet. Okay. Weep, weep, weep. Professor Moreau's diary. Oh, okay. Hang around inside my force implement additional security measures. So to secure the premises with a simple mechanical apparatus. I've installed a mechanism for locking and unlocking doors by just operated by pressing four protruding stones placed high up on the wall. So I can bypass this lock by using it as a simple spell, but a common thief will be faced with a double challenge. Notice the stones and puzzle out their purpose, then you must find a way to press them. Okay. Alright, well, we've got a big rock. Oh boy. About to face another panther. Quen is very high powered, so that helps us out. Cool, let's take some gold. I love gold. Alright. Check out this side room just to be sure. Nothing in here. Okay. Alright, so let's continue on to Professor Moreau's diary. The location that he said. This must be our grave robber. Okay. So it seems like this...
Not bad. Wouldn't mind having something like that myself.
If I hit these, that, okay. Now, will I hit one of the stones? That must not be the right way. Try and hit that one. Okay. Okay. Is that all of them then?
Did it.
I don't remember hitting that one in front of us. But I'm not gonna complain. Get the lots of gold.
Interesting as places go. Seems someone put a lot of thought into its design.
Oh, look around.
Impressive. It's just decoration.
Guest! Intruder! You are not welcome.
Yeah, not as much.
Oh. Got you, though. Okay. So, now we've got to figure out a way to go forward. I think that you light this. Oh. Put the gargoyle paw there. Weigh it down. Okay.
Great. Portals. This just keeps getting better.
Okay. Let's put the sword away. Let's go into the right one.
Damn it. Back where I started.
Okay. Alright, so this is where we came from. I went in the right one. That took us to the center one. If I go in the left one... What does it do? Takes us upstairs. Perfect. Okay. So I've got... That's the one I came out of.
Right. Gotta find the next portal.
We've got right, center, or left. I'm gonna go right. And we're back where we started.
Back where I started.
Alright, so it's left first. Came out of this one. I'm going to assume we can't go in that one.
Alright, now to find the next portal.
Alright, we did left, then we try to go center. Let's go left, right. Nope.
Damn it, wrong again. Could be some clue around here.
Maybe the hand?
Right. Gotta find the next portal.
Maybe it's just left, left. No.
Damn it. Back where I started.
Okay. Alright, so it's left first. Go back this way.
Damn it. Back where I started.
Yeah, okay.
All right, right. Gotta find the next portal.
It's almost like it's the one that he's looking at. Oh, I guess we can't keep going that way. I don't think I did this one. I might have. I'm losing track.
Statues seem oddly oriented, as if to all face in one direction. The right portal, maybe?
That's what I thought, yeah. Okay, can't go that way.
Right. Gotta find the next portal.
So... okay, can't go that way. That's the issue. How do I get over there? That's the million-dollar question we have. Do I jump down and then go again? Yeah, because unless I'm being dumb, I can't get over there. Take a swallow, eat some meat. Let me try going this one again. No.
Damn it, back where I started.
Okay, so I go through this one, and I end up here.
How to find the next portal.
Oh, I think I was being dumb. Yeah, okay. Like I said, I was being pretty dumb, so yeah, you just climb down, go up here.
Alright, gotta find the next portal.
Now we're on the top level, he's facing... not this one. Not this one. Seems to be he's facing this one. I seem to have found something. Ah, there we go.
Had his lab.
Search the laboratory. Okay, it's steps. Why is Geralt having such an issue with steps? Probably not. I'm not breaking him out though. Ooh, we've got
his machinery goes. But how do I start it up?
Okay. Megascope crystal. Ah, cool. Greater green mutagen. Let me read that book. Centipedes. Alright, so yeah, I know we've got a megascope over here.
Crystals. Should mount them in the megascope. Missing two crystals. Just need to pick an entry. Crystal for this entry's missing. Might be somewhere. Should look around.
Okay, first entry. I don't know what this is doing. Oh, okay.
The 18th of Yule, year 1102. Today I begin my great life's endeavor, one greater and more significant than any I have thus far undertaken. For it relates to me personally, to myself and my son. When 15 years passed, a beast of the forest assaulted me. A witcher came to my aid, saved my life. I could not know that for said salvation, I would in the end pay by relinquishing any say as to my own son's fate.
Wow.
Had I the skill to turn back time, I would have done so, and perished rather than surrender to the Witcher as my only son. But as it was, on the day when Jerome was taken, I swore an oath on my honor that I would recover my son. Today, following years of research and preparation, I have at last devised a device that allows me to study mutations. If the gods in their goodness grant me but a bit of favor, I shall find a way to reverse said mutations and restore Jerome to a normal life.
Wow. Okay.
So, Professor wasn't out to enhance Witcher mutations, wanted to reverse them. Wonder if he managed, and if there's anything in it for me.
Alright, let's take a look at the second entry.
Observation 22. Despite applying a surfeit of toxic substances, significantly more than usual, the subject displayed no symptoms of overdosing. I believe this to be an effect of the mutations. Thus, a minor success. This mutation should allow Jerome better to tolerate toxicity.
Okay, which we sort of already know from Geralt. Let's look at the third one. I don't have the fourth crystal, but we can probably search the lab and find that one.
Observation number 30. The mutations do not set in at once. Curiously, they do not develop over a span of time. Rather, for a mutation to progress towards completion, the appropriate mutagen must be applied continuously. The subject does not bear this well, but I found a way to make the mutations less taxing, invasive. To the mutagen base, I add the albumin of a mutated giant centipede egg. Stored in a glass terrarium, the eggs do not develop, remain small. The eggs themselves are a sight to behold. Mutated, they are luminescent, emitting a wondrous glow. I can only hope my addition of the albumin will produce no significant side effects. Time will tell.
Can I not view number 5? No, I have to view the 5th. I didn't mean to look at this so early. I thought that, you know, I could at least back out.
Years of experiments. Research. Sacrifice. All for naught. I have failed to achieve my defined objective. Each mutation I applied to my subjects proved ineffective when applied to Jerome. What I meant to cure him of his witcherism, that which I meant to restore to him a normal life, only deepened his mutations, further augmented his speed and strength, rendered him yet more inhuman. It seems my son must remain a witcher forever. I have failed. The time has come to abandon this place. Return home to Lydia. She may yet deign to take me back.
Wow, okay.
The contraption and mutagens I leave here. Let them wither and crumble. As did my dreams of regaining my son.
So the professor wanted to reverse the mutation's effects. Ended up deepening them. Stroke of luck for me. Could profit from his failure.
Yeah. Well.
So, professor tried to neutralize the effects of Witcher mutations. Only managed to enhance them, though. Used the albumins of giant centipede eggs as his mutagen base. Need to go on an egg hunt.
Cool. Let's sort of take a look around here.
Quite the library. Mostly tomes on mutations and genetics.
Nice. Cool. Let's find that other There it is, the Megascope Crystal.
Preserved organs. Hope their donors weren't forced to give them up.
Pretty sure they were. Okay, so this is sort of the way out, it seems. We can tell it's a portal, and you've got the sort of the usual thing which we do hard at. Yeah, okay. Let's go listen to that final entry, and then we can decide where to go from there. Alright, yeah, we're gonna listen to the last one.
This crystal must go here. All crystals in place. Show me what you got. Just need to pick an entry.
Yeah, we're gonna listen to the fourth. Which we didn't before, of course.
Observation 58. Sometimes failure is the catalyst for success. I've discovered a method by which one type of mutagen may be transmuted into another through the addition of certain ingredients. This is a great day for science. In addition, I observed that today's dose of mutagens brought the subject to the brink of death. He then suddenly awoke, revived, his strength renewed. Not wholly, of course, but he did in a sense come back from the edge of death. Whether this is attributable to his mutations or to pure coincidence cannot be ascertained. I must conduct further experiments.
Okay. Good to know that you can transmute the different types then.
Seems a relief.
So, yeah. Our next job is to head deeper in through that way and try and get some giant centipede albumen from getting their eggs. But for now, I think we'll save that for part 12. So we have gone through, we completely cured Vivienne of her curse. She's now normal. Guillaume wasn't too happy, but what are you going to do? And we've found the professor's laboratory, and we're gonna try and enhance some of our Witcher abilities with some additional mutations. So that's what we'll probably do in part 12. We'll continue with that and finish up any other side missions. As I've said in previous parts, main story is not what we're going for just yet. So the next few parts are still gonna be side missions and trying to get all of those out of the way. Maybe not all of them, maybe do a few more, head back to the main story, sort of flip-flop between them, that way we're not diverting from the main story too much. Thanks everyone for watching. Be sure to let me know how the videos are going in the comment section below. Let me know the audio, video, if everything's okay or not. At this point, I might be switching over to a new graphics card, not sure just yet if I want to get, if the RX 480s are out and if they are promising, I might pick up one of those since they're should be pretty cheap, but we'll see, and hopefully in the future, then either by buying that graphics card or doing a whole PC upgrade, we're going to have some higher quality videos to go with. So yeah, again, thanks everyone for watching. Be sure to keep checking in every Saturday for these videos, and hopefully you're liking them. Thanks everybody, this is Tatman, signing off.